Welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on satellite communication trainer. In this video I am going to give a complete description about the working of satellite communication. We will study the uplink transmitter, downlink receiver and satellite transponder respectively. In this video I will explain you all the features of this complete trainer kit, and also we will perform some experiments on the trainer kit to understand the satellite communication. Without wasting any time, let us move on to the experiment section along with the explanation of all the features. So this is the complete setup of satellite communication trainer with all the modules and the accessories. The order code is 10203. You can use this order code to find out all the specification related about it and to purchase it from our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. So the satellite communication trainer comes in different parts. The first one is uplink transmitter, then this is the downlink receiver, and this is the satellite transponder, which can behave from transmitter and receiver from both the type of communication. And this is the user manual with this, and a mic for providing an input signal, which will be studied in the experiment section, and a desktop monitor for taking out the output of audio video communications. Now we will study all the parts one by one, and later on we will perform experiments on this trainer. So this is our uplink transmitter from the satellite communication trainer. The uplink transmitter has the different features, like this has a selectable frequency selector switch, which can be select the frequency from 2468, 2390, 2510 and 2490 megahertz in the range. You can easily move this frequency selector switch and select the frequency. LED indication will be provided at which frequency we are working. This frequency transmits three signals simultaneously at each uplink frequency. 4 megahertz clock frequency is inbuilt. Wideband RF amplifier is also provided with this. Frequency up down selection with the LED indication is provided. This is the on off switch for uplink transmitter to on and off. And this is the on-off switch for voice signal, which has an inbuilt sine wave tone generator. The tone will be provided from this output terminal, and an inbuilt data carrier wave, which gives a uniform data to transmit for a sample, which will be transformed in the 100 or 1011 in the binary digits. That will be transmitted from the data terminals over here. We can also use this microphone to connect it at the mic terminal provided over here, so that we can transmit the voice signals through the satellite communication. We are also providing a detachable antenna, which can be easily assembled on the all the trainer slots, and this is the BNC connector, so that you can easily connect it from the antenna, and your transmitter is ready to transmit the signals from the satellite. Now this is the second part of this complete setup. This is the satellite transponder. It works as a receiver and transmitter in both the condition, which is a satellite transponder which orbits in the outer space. It resembles the same satellite that will link with uplink and downlink, uplink transmitter and downlink receiver. Transponder with the selectable frequency of 2390, 2468, 2490 and 2510 megahertz. All the different frequency can be selectable from both the frequency selection switch. On off for the receiver for the transponder is provided, and the similar transmitter switch for on off is also provided. This is the receiver audio signal. You can directly provide RCA signal to check that the uplink transmitter link will be working or not. Now move on to the next part of this satellite communication trainer. So this is the third part of this satellite communication trainer. This is the downlink receiver. Antenna is already installed on that. Similar procedure to install the antenna, as I explained earlier, on both the transponder and the downlink receiver also. Similarly, there are frequency selector switch at which all the transmitter works, whether it is a transponder or a direct uplink transmitter, you have to select the same frequency range from the selector switch so that the receiver will be receive the same frequency ranges. The speaker on off button is also provided, and a volume controller is also provided for this. The speaker is inbuilt over here so that you can receive all the voice signals on this speaker. Then we have output terminals of RCA connectors for receiving the audio video signals from the satellite communication, and the data signal for receiving the data output from the uplink transmitter or through the transponder. Now we will move to the experimental setup. We will power on all the kits with the 220 volt power supply. Patch cords or power cords are provided with the complete setup. Now I will set up the complete trainer and we will experiment some basic functions. So now moving to our experiment 1, which states that understanding the basic concept of satellite communication, which is a theoretical concept which will be explained in the complete user manual. You can study it with all the different points, which is a detailed explanation about the satellite communication working. You can study it before going on to the other experiments. Now we will move to the second experiment, which is the first practical, which is the experiment 2. The objective of this experiment 2 is to establish a direct communication link between uplink transmitter and downlink receiver. Apparatus for this is required: uplink transmitter, dish antennas, downlink receivers and connecting cables. The procedure is given as follows. We will follow the procedure and find out the result. So now for the setup, we have already prepared all the settings that we have connected antenna with the BNC cable on the uplink transmitter. Similarly, we have connected the dish antenna on the downlink receiver with the BNC cable. Now we will power on both the switches and power on the uplink transmitter and receiver unit like this. And over here right now you can see only the power LED of the on off switch is glowing. When we turn on this uplink on off switch, the LEDs will indicate that the transmitter antenna is working, the transmitter unit is working, uplink transmitter, and the selection LED of the frequency selection switch will be give you the selection idea. Right now the frequency selection is 2510 megahertz. We can change it using the frequency selection port. So we'll set it to any of the frequency. Let us say we'll set it to 2390, and similarly we will turn on the receiver side, the downlink receiver, with this downlink on off button. So we turn on the downlink receiver on off switch like this, and here we can see the selected frequency from the selector switch LED is glowing now. So we can adjust the frequency at any of the desired frequency level. We will set it to the similar frequency as we have set it on the uplink transmitter. So we will set it to 2390 megahertz. Now we will provide a tone signal, which is an inbuilt tone generator, on the uplink transmitter. So for that we will use a patch code, connect it to the tone output over here, and we will provide this to the tone input on the audio 2 or audio 1 jack. Now on the other hand, there is a speaker on off button, so we will turn this switch to the on and turn the volume controller to the maximum. So we'll turn on the speaker and carefully slowly turn on the volume controller to the maximum output. So here we can see the tone signal is receiving from uplink to downlink receiver, which is a direct link between uplink and downlink receiver. If I change the frequency, there will be distortion on the output as I have changed the frequency from 2510 2390 to 2510, and if I again change the frequency from the transmitter side to match up with both, we will see the signal will be proper distortion free. So that's how we create the uplink transmitter link. So this is the conclusion of this experiment. Similarly, the data output is also provided here. We can provide the data output to the data signal and we can receive the data on the output link. Now for the experiment number 3, to set up the active satellite link and demonstrate the link fail operation. Similarly, all the connections and setup that we have created for the last experiment, we will set up all the things similarly and we will turn on the power of transmitter and receiver, and we will see the link will be established in both of them. So for that, for link fail operation, either we can turn off the uplink transmitter. So here you can see there is no clear tone signal on the speaker output, which is a complete distortion. So that's how we can see the link is failed, because transmitter stops working. If I again turn on the transmitter, the link will again established, and similar process will be happen on the downlink receiver also. As I turn off the downlink receiver, all the speakers and outputs will be go off, and here you can see the receiver unit is stopped working. That's how we cannot receive any signal. Now moving to experiment number 5, the experiment number 4 will be explained later. To communicate the voice signal through satellite link, for this we required uplink transmitter, dish antennas, downlink receiver, connecting cables and active mic. The mic is provided with the complete setup. We will follow the procedure and set the voice signals from the mic to the receiver end. For this, we have to connect the mic to the mic terminal on the uplink receiver. The mic is provided. So now the mic is ready to use, and we will connect the mic jack to the mic jack socket. Place the mic in on position. Turn on the uplink transmitter, set the frequency to a desired value. We'll set it to 2390. And on the downlink receiver, we will match the similar frequency. Turn on the downlink receiver and match the similar frequency 2390, and turn on the speaker. Here right now no signal is receiving. I am placing my camera mic nearby to the speaker output on the downlink receiver,
and as I speak, something, the mic output will be from the speaker on the downlink receiver. I am speaking all the words right now from the mic. You can see the distorting voice, slightly distorted voice from the mic output over here, and that's how we can establish the uplink transmitter with the downlink receiver for the voice signal.
So that's how we establish the mic communication for voice communication from one end to other end on the uplink transmitter to downlink receiver. After doing the experiment, turn off both the transmitter and receiver. Carefully pull out the mic, and you can easily unplug it and place it with the box provided. Now moving to our fourth experiment that I have said, we will explain it later. So in the fourth experiment, we will establish the audio video satellite link between transmitter and receiver. For that, the apparatus we required is mentioned over here: uplink transmitter, dish antennas, downlink receiver connecting cables, and satellite transponder. The transceiver section, which will behave as a spacecraft or the satellite on the orbit, and audio video input for VCD to be connected on uplink transmitter, will connect a VCD. The VCD is I've already set up over here, and a monitor, the TV monitor to be downlink receiver, that I have already set up over here. I will also explain you the how to connect monitor with the powers and connect it to the receiver section. We'll follow the procedure and establish the connection and set the frequency with the link between uplink transmitter and transponder, which will be on the other frequency, and receiver section from the transponder and the downlink receiver will be on the different frequencies, so that we can easily establish connection with different frequency bands. So firstly, we will connect the VCD output RCA that I have connected. Red one is connected to the video output and white one is connected to audio output. So we'll both connect to the video output. Don't go to the color, because cable is slightly faulty that we have using over here. So red one is connected to the video output of the VCD and white one is connected to the audio output of the VCD. Now for connecting the monitor, the cable is provided with this. This is the red one is the power socket that will be connected to the adapter of the monitor. This is the output channel that will be going to connect the monitor. The lead is provided, which is inbuilt with the monitor, and the yellow one will be the video input for the monitor. We will be connect it to the video RC output on the receiver section. For that, similarly, we will connect the adapter with the red one and connect the adapter to the power socket, the 220 volt power socket, which gives the 12 volt output in DC. And this end of this connecting cable will be connected with the monitor. As we connect the monitor, the power will on, and here it will showing you the different options for giving output. And this is the audio output of this cable, which will be connected on the video RCA connector. Now we will turn on all the devices: the uplink transmitter. Turn on the uplink transmitter on-off switch, which is already on over here. Now we will turn on the satellite communication trainer, the satellite transponder. Both the receiver and transmitter is turned on. Antennas that I have already set up over here, so you can set them. Now set the frequency at 2468, or you can set it to 2390, but make sure the receiver and transmitter links frequency will be at a suitable distance, so that no distortion will be mixed out. Now we have set the 2468 frequency on the uplink transmitter. Similar frequency will be set on the 2468 on the receiver section of the satellite transponder. Now we will set the frequency that will be not visible right now due to the antenna, so I am removing the antenna. So as I have detached the antenna to explain the frequency selection on the frequency transmitter. The transmitter frequency is selected to 2510. You can select it to any of the other three available frequencies, because the first frequency selection that we have set on the transmitter link. So we'll set it to 2510. So I will again place the antenna properly. So antenna is placed properly again. Now we'll turn off the, turn on the downlink receiver and set the frequency on 2510, as we have selected 2510 on the transponder as well. Now we'll turn on the speaker and maximize the volume. Here you can see the voice output from the VCD player is right now hearable on the speaker, and for the video output we'll turn on the video and select it to the movie icon. Over here you can see the video is displayed on the monitor. And as I play the video, paused, you can see the video output on the monitor. And that's how we establish the audio video link between uplink transmitter, satellite transponder and downlink receiver. If you find something distortions on the video output, you can slightly change the frequency and check your established output. If I change the frequency, here you can see the frequency link is mismatched in uplink transmitter and transponder, so we can not getting the video. And similar frequency, if I change it to the satellite transponder, we will see some video output. Here you can see the frequency is slightly closer, so that the output is distorting. We will again change the frequency to the lower one, and here we can see the output is visible on the monitor. So that's how we establish the link, and that's how satellite communication trainer works. We can also understand the link file operation with this setup also. If I turn off the receiver antenna or the receiver section of the transponder, you can see there are no output, whether it is audio or video, no output is receiving on the receiver end. And if I turn on it again, you will receive the video and audio output on both. For video output, we have to again turn on the monitor and we can have the video output. So that's how we can explain and demonstrate the link file operation with the transponder, uplink transmitter and downlink receiver as well. And now for experiment 7, we will transmit the receive 3 separate signal, audio, video, tone simultaneously with this complete setup. For this, we can either use the function generator over here so that we can easily provide any input on the audio jack, audio signal and the tone signal that is already inbuilt in the transmitter section, uplink transmitter, we can use also. All the setup for audio video link is already done over here, so we just need to connect the patch code with the tone signal on the uplink transmitter, and we will connect it to the audio 2 input with the audio which is fetching from the VCD player. Now we'll turn on the uplink transmitter, transponder and receiver. So here we can see the tone signal is also we can hear on the output, and video signal on the monitor and audio signal with the speaker. On the monitor we can only, on this desktop monitor, we can only connect the video signal for this. And if you are using a television, you can easily connect the audio one output and feed the audio one output at this terminal. So you can receive the audio output on the television as well separately. Now for the experiment number 8, which is the last experiment of this complete setup, which is to transmit receive the function generator waveforms through satellite link. The inbuilt waveform or data signal is provided on the uplink transmitter over here. You can use that or you can use a separately function generator. For this we will do it with both of the method. So we'll follow the procedure, same procedure for setting up the waveform and the full communication of the uplink transmitter, transponder and downlink receiver. We will in the last we'll set the and fed, we can set the signal of 1 kilohertz sine wave with the data inputs on the uplink transmitter, and we can change the waveforms and get the output on the CRO. So I have already set up the CRO, and firstly we will connect the data signal, which is a inbuilt data generator signs, which gives 1011 in the binary bits, which will be received on the data signal. I have already set the frequency of the uplink transmitter at 2510. Receiver of trans receiver will be having the 2510 same link in between both, and the transmitter and the transmitter section of the trans receiver transponder having frequency set up on 2390 and similar frequency at the downlink receiver 2390. Now we'll transmit the data. For this we'll use this patch code which is provided with the trainer setup, connect it to the data terminal of output over here. I will turn the antenna for slightly visibility of the uplink transmitters, and there is a data terminal output over here. You can connect the data to the data terminal. Now for checking the output, the link is already established in between them. So as we have selected frequencies already, now we'll use the test probe of the CRO or the DSO that we are using over here. Connect ground to the ground terminal and data to the data terminal. You have to slightly adjust the scale and you will get the data on the CRO or the DSO. The data is 1011 in the binary form, which is giving us the square waveform slightly. And for taking up the different signals, you can also use the function generator. Now we will send the function generator waveforms from satellite links. For this I have already set up a function generator over here. You can see I have set the function generator on 1 kHz sine wave frequency to generate the sine waveform of 1 kHz at 2 volt peak to peak output in the amplitude. I will connect it to the ground and data terminal of the uplink transmitter. Frequencies I do not change, and the same frequencies selections is already set up as earlier. Now for receiving the output, we will connect again the CRO ground to ground terminal and positive to data terminal, and here you can see we are receiving the sine waveform. If I check the measures, the frequency is about 1 kHz and amplitude slightly closed down because there are some losses in the output. So whenever we transmit some signals, the desired signals will be transmitted at the higher level which are required from the receiving end. And we can also change the waveforms on the function generator. Like we can change it to square waveform, and you can see the square waveform output is showing over on the CRO. and similarly we can change the frequency to triangular waveform as well, and triangular output is also provided. You have to adjust the CRO level all time, and there will be always some type of distortion because this is a explanation model of the satellite communication, and this is the complete setup so that you can easily understand the satellite communication with this complete functioning. That was the complete demonstration of satellite communication trainer. You can do all the experiments as I explained in this video, and still if you find difficulties, you can refer the user manual or contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. Thank you.